You know, that's a, constantly saying. See, because once you get saved, that don't mean you just don't ever tell God to fill you. You got to be filled every day.
That's right.
Amen.
That's right, Pastor. That's right.
Every time you drink a glass of water, you want some more, you refill it, right?
Amen. That's right. That's right.
That's the same way we have to ask the Lord.
That's right.
Fill us, Lord.
Fill us up.
Yeah. That's what we do before we come out. Fill us, Lord, till we overflow. Not only while we're here, but wherever we at. Amen. We just thank God. Amen. For the choirs.
Amen.
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 Oh, you men are low faith. I was kind of shaking this morning. But I didn't know what, how are you going to sound without me? I'm talking to you too, man. Ain't no shame in my game. Amen. Y'all
did a marvelous
job.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen. May the Holy Ghost have his way. He can do all things. Amen. I just thank God so much. I want to take a moment here to thank God for Mother Carol. And
amen. Amen.
Mother Randolph and Mother Owens.
Yes. Hallelujah.
Church, we need to get their spiritual guidance.
Amen.
They done been through the fire.
Yes.
We going through it, so, you know, we fight battles. Sometimes we don't have to fight them. If we go to some seasoned people that already, that God have dealt with, amen. So we want to lean on them and ask them quick. I ain't saying nothing about no foolishness now. But no foolishness. Amen. 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 We want to lean. I thank God for you all so much. Amen. 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 We can't do enough for them. We can't do enough for them. But we can't show that we love them. Amen. Bless the Lord. Amen. That's right. That's right. Give them that flower, Father. Yeah, yeah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Ah, hallelujah. I hear a song in my soul. I've been through the storm. To the men, I pray to God that this is not for no embarrassment or nothing like that. I follow the Holy Spirit, what the Holy Spirit tells me to do. Amen. 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 Because when He created us, we're supposed to be leaders. Amen. And we got to stop from the back door. We got to come to the front door.
All right.
Stand up for right and righteous.
All right.
Amen. Amen. Don't they look good? Don't they look good?
Amen.
I thank God for you all. Amen. I thank God. I don't mean in here today. I've seen you alone.
Amen.
Amen.
I thank God. I haven't forgotten about you, young ladies. Your day coming. Amen. But it's just these young men today.
Amen.
I thank God for Sister Mills. Y'all see Sister
Amen.
Mills.
Amen.
You don't know the story.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Amen. This is an anointed young lady of God. We don't talk much like we used to, but I tell you, she got faith. And it's bigger than a mustard seed. I thank God for how she's helping people, doing things in South Carolina and in various places. I thank God for you. Amen. Amen. I want to show y'all something. See, God put jewels in the midst of you. But if you don't use them, he'll take them away. She tried to do a lot when she was here and got kicked a lot. Y'all know I don't keep nothing.
Uh-uh, speak it.
But God sent her to South Carolina where she'll be appreciated. But her journey and purpose is not over. I'm looking for her to be back one day. Come on, give her a hand.
Church, Cornerstone Assembly of Faith, Pentecostal, but by the same token, they preach the word. That's all I gotta say, they preach the word. Live by the word, like you said, tithe, pay your tithes and offers. Pay your tithes and offers. I don't care what you might like, what you might want to do.
Amen. 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 Everywhere you go. Later on. Amen. You want to sing? You gotta let him sing later on. All right. You gonna sing later on, okay? All right. Mike wanted to sing this song, but maybe at the end of the service, I let him sing. Amen. Yeah. Okay, he gonna sing God did it at the end of the service.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
And that singing like we sang it, but he sang it.
Amen. That's right, Pastor.
Amen. We thank God today. We give him honor, glory, and praise. We just thank him so much for our life. Amen. And we give him all the honor and to Reverend Cooper, Evan upstairs. Amen. Minister Morgan while we're working. Amen. But we thank God. Amen. Amen. We know that Ms. Wright is with her daughter down in Florida. But nevertheless, we are moving on up Zion. The farther I go, the better I feel.
Yes, sir.
I think I'm mad at Sister Mills, Mom didn't tell you nothing wrong.
All right.
You don't take the Lord. This right. Journey gonna be hard to run.
Yes, yes.
You gotta take the Lord.
As sure as you want.
Amen. 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 We're gonna get ready to preach here and teach or whatever the Lord allows us to do. But I want you to know that the Lord is really blessing. I thank God for Ricky.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
We talk about three times a week, and I bless the Lord, how the Lord is elevating him.
Amen.
Amen. He almost had me shouting one day on the phone.
Watch out, Pastor. Watch out.
Amen.
I feel good. Watch out.
He told me, he said, Pastor, you know, I got my phone and the word on it. He said, but you know, I want to get the Bible. The Bible.
Amen.
You know, I found out, Ricky, I had an iPad myself. But ain't nothing like holding the word.
That's right. There's nothing like holding it. Nothing like holding it. That's right.
All this technology is fine. But see, like when I hold it in my hand, like I'm lifting him up.
That's right. That's right.
Oh, my God. Do you have your Bible this morning? Do you have no Bible, no sword, no shotgun?
Yes, sir, yes, sir.
Are they loaded this morning?
Yes.
Don't fool me now. Is it loaded? Because we're going to blow the devil out the water. Ah, let's repeat. This is the living word of God.
This is the living word of God.
I can't can hear you. This is the living word of God.
This is the living word of God.
I can be what he says I can be.
I can be what he says I can be.
Come on, say it like you mean it. I can be what he says
I can be.
And I stand on his promise.
I stand on his promise.
Come on, give him some praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It's the living word of God. This morning, I want to come from the book of John, amen, the 6th chapter and the 35th verse. 6th chapter of John, amen, the 35th verse. I'm going to read from the 35th down to the 40th, what the Lord has given me. Once you have this, amen.
Amen.
If you could stand, please stand. Let us reverence God's word.
That's right.
Amen. 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 In the word of God here, it said, then Jesus declared, I am the bread of life. He who comes to me will never go hungry. And he who believes in me will never be thirsty. But as I told you, you have seen me and still you do not believe. All that the Father give me will come to me. And whoever comes to me, I will never drive away. For I have come down from heaven not to do my will, but to the will of him who sent me. And this is the will of him who sent me, that I shall lose none of all that he has given me, but raise them up in the last day. For my Father's will is that everyone, somebody say everyone, who looks to the Son and believe in him shall have eternal life, and I will raise him up at the last day. With the permission of the Holy Spirit, I want to talk from this subject this morning, good news.
Good news. Hallelujah.
I want to talk from the subject, good news. Here in this chapter here, it began talking about Jesus feeding the 5,000. And you all know about the 5 barley loaves and the 2 fish.
Yeah.
And the multitude came and sat down with Jesus and he fed them.
Yeah.
When he finished, he went on the other side of the water, told the disciples, said, you go over on the other side.
Yeah.
I stopped by to tell you we got some good news. As he went on the other side, Jesus came later. But the group of people looked and they knew didn't but one boat go on the other side.
Right.
Well, how did he get over there? You know, but the Bible said, here comes Jesus walking on the water.
Yes, sir. Take your time. Take your time.
I stop by to tell you, see, sometimes you can get arrogant. Just like Peter said, Lord, if it's you, forbid me to come. If Peter hadn't been so arrogant, he would have stayed in the boat with the rest of them.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Come on, Doc. Take your time. See, I wish I had some help here. See, some people do things for show. See, Peter got out of the boat and started walking toward Jesus.
Yes, sir.
But it's not in the Bible, but I believe Jesus ran in his mind and said, you're not all of that.
No.
No. It's my job to walk on the water.
That's right.
I haven't seen a man yet walk on the water. So when Peter started coming to him, he didn't have to say a word, but the wind started blowing and the water started whipping, and Peter started going down. Jesus had to grab it. What I'm trying to tell you, be real. Whatever you do, be real.
That's right.
Can I get a witness here? Really, you don't have to prove nothing to people, but everything to God.
That's right.
Let me tell you something.
Glory.
See, a lot of people has confessed Christ, but they haven't had what's on the inside rooted out. Can I get a witness here?
Yeah.
See, you could take a lawnmower and cut your grass.
That's right.
But you're not getting to the root of it. Can I get a witness here?
That's right.
You really don't see unless you request it. When they cut a tree down, they cut it level sometimes, but they never get all the root out.
That's
right. See, long as the root is in the ground, it's gonna still try to grow.
Take your time,
see, some church folks need to go back to the moaning beach and tell God, I need to be rooted out. Because, see, long as that lion spirit is in you, it's going to continue until God get down to the root. But a lot of people don't want to go to the root because the root hurts. When you start digging the root, it hurts. If you ever had a tooth extracted, when you start, if they don't shoot you with enough Novocaine, when they pull it, it hurts.
Amen.
See, a lot of people has been married. Don't run out now. Don't run out of it. And have been separated.
Uh-huh.
And that's the reason you can't keep nobody. Because the same mess we were with the first man, we think the second man gonna be the same way. Same thing with the women, same thing with the men.
That's right.
Then you don't have a bad woman, you boy, don't got quiet in here. You think the one you got is just like the first one that was cutting out on you. You need to be rooted out. Ask God to create within me a clean.
That's it.
I'm preaching somebody get delivered this morning. God told me to tell you, you can't control nobody. That's a bad spirit. When you try to control people, you need to be rooted out. You can't be free until you root it out. That's why men and women are leaving out the marriage, because one or another haven't been rooted out. Y'all don't hear me this morning. There's no need to get married a second or third time if you're going to keep the first marriage in your mind. As we as believers of God, we got to trust Him that this marriage is going to be a success. Even though they may have the traits. Y'all what you have been through before. But if you are a prayer warrior, God will work it out.
Yes, He will. Yes, He will.
Good news. That's good news. Can I get a witness here? You can't go on your job tomorrow and use those 3 and 4 letter words. I'm not talking about God either. And then by Thursday, you want to tell somebody how good God is. The Bible said hot water and cold water don't come out the same speaking at the same time. I got you this morning. I'm out here. Can I get a witness here? Men, let the women be women, and men, you be men. If you're married to them, why are you jealous? When my wife go, at least I know one thing. I might not know what she had, but I know what she's coming back to. I said, what would I be doing when she come in the house? I have a remote in my hand. And I don't ask her where you coming from, because I don't want to know. She might tell me the truth. The best way to help each other is when they come in, love upon them. If you can't have nothing to say, don't say nothing at all. All right. Lord, you told me to say it, man. But see, Satan has got a smooth way of doing things, church. We got to be watchful. We got to be watchful. Because he's so smooth. If you save and your husband save it, he's watching and you watching, that rascal get your son and daughter. They're getting cutting up and you get weary. I'm telling you from experience, I know. But what we can do, we can't throw them to the wolves. You got to pray. Call them in and talk to them. I've learned all I get. You can't raise your voice. But you got to be humble with these children. Can I get a witness here? If you want them to tell you the truth, call. When they come in and they tell you the truth, you get upset. Don't say nothing then. Go back later and say, okay, well, that was wrong. I'm telling you the mistakes I made. But once they see you're not going to get upset, they'll come back. I made a mistake. Please forgive me. You know, we made mistakes. I got three people saying amen. No, I don't have to say amen. Some of y'all made one before you came to church. I know y'all think I'm crazy.
Teach the word.
But look, let me. Thank you, Jesus. But look at here. When Jesus was walking on the water, and the people gathered around and they came on the other side, and Jesus looked, and he began to tell them, said, "You didn't come to get help. You come because I fed you." Can I get a witness here? See, some people come get the word so they can be better. Some people come to church out of formality. Can I get a witness here? You know one thing the Lord shared with me this morning, Ricky? You could come to noonday prayer. You could come to Bible study. You could sit in Sunday school and be in 10 o'clock service. Satan don't care. He don't care you sitting in all of that. But he cares when you start implementing the word of God to your life. That's when you get mad.
That's when you get mad.
You never seen two boxers arguing about Whitney Train. But when he go the night before to get weighed, and he look at, see how lean and how they are built,
then
they get upset because they know the trainer is teaching them right.
Amen.
That's the same way Bible study is.
Yeah.
See, long as you don't put it into action,
it don't mean nothing. It don't mean nothing.
Talk about it, doctor.
But when you start saying, for God I live and for God I die, I'm going to walk in the commandments of God. I'm not going to lie. I'm not going to steal. I'm not going to fornicate. That's when he bring out the sledgehammer. That's when he start whacking on you. But I'm telling you, no need to come into all these places if you're not going to implement the word.
That's it.
Because this is the only way. She just got through singing it. You got to take the Lord. How you going to take it if you don't have the word in you?
Can't take it.
Then the Bible says, Jesus told them, he had told them about the bread. Yeah. He told them, I tell you the truth, it is not Moses who's giving you the bread from heaven, but it's my Father who's giving you the true bread from heaven.
Yeah.
For the bread of God is he who come down from heaven and give life to the world.
Yes.
See, the thing about it is, we need the natural bread.
Yeah.
That's for the physical body.
Yes, sir.
But we need the bread, spiritual bread, for the bread of life.
Yes.
Can I get a witness here?
Yes.
Till Jesus called him, said, look here, ah, I am the bread of life.
Yes, sir. Yes,
he who come to me will never go hungry.
Yes, sir.
And he who believes in me will never be thirsty.
Yes,
I stop by to tell you tonight.
Yes.
When you get a little hungry, he'll feed you.
Yes, sir.
Can I get a witness here?
Yes.
It's just like the computer. When you want to pull up something.
Yes, sir.
When you hit the right button, it'll come back up.
Yes.
Can I get a witness here?
Amen.
If you got the word of God down on the inside, the man of heaven will come down and feed you.
Yes,
can I get a witness here?
Amen.
If you're thirsty, he'll give you water from the fountain where you never have had the word being thirsty again. Lord, have mercy. Church, that's what we need. We need that manna from on high.
Yeah.
Can I get a witness here?
Yeah.
You will have to go through trials and tribulations.
Yes, sir.
But the manna from on high is worth it.
Yeah.
I wish I had some help here.
Yes, sir.
Long as you got a relationship with Jesus.
Yeah.
Can I get a witness here?
Yeah.
No wonder he called himself the bread of life.
Yeah.
That's why I thank God. But the bread must be eaten to sustain life. Can I get a witness? Christ must be invited into our daily walk and to sustain our spiritual life. But I stop by to tell you, that's why you got to have a prayer life.
That's right.
Can I get a witness?
That's right. That's right.
You can't pray just when you're in trouble. You need to be praying 24/7. Can I get a witness? Because one day I stop by to tell you, something might happen and you can't pray. Can I get a witness here? Because a lot of old people say I'm sitting up my temple every day. Can I get a witness here? Because we don't know when and we don't know where that you might need to get a prayer through. I wish I had some help.
Come on, Pastor. Come on.
Even in the wicked and the midnight hour, when all the troubles surround us, when you done sitting up your temple. God hears your cry. When you're late at night, you can't sleep. God has learned the temple. That's why you got to ask God. And you don't have to ask him. Because when you walk upright, he'll walk with you.
That's right.
Can I get a witness?
Do I
have any people wake up at night?
Just
telling God, I love you so much. God, I'm so thankful. worthy, but look how you look out for me. You my bread for the hungry. You my food on the table. Oh my God, I stopped by to tell you,
good news.
That is 36 verse, she said, but as I told you, you have seen me, and still you do not believe. You know, God has worked so many miracles. He has done what no man can do.
That's right.
And it bothers me when people say, I'm a child of God, still don't believe he's a miracle worker.
That's right.
Can I get a witness out? Oh, it's got quiet in here. Let me tell you something. When you believe and know Jesus for yourself, you don't have to get on the phone and call nobody else. They used to say, I got a telephone in my booth. I can call him anytime. Lord have mercy. When I'm riding along, can I get some help here? I can call him. I say, Jesus, you are the Lamb of God. Jesus, you are the light of the world. You are my Father.
That's right, Pastor Graham.
My God. And it says, all that the Father gives me will come to me. See, the thing about it is, we can't make it come.
That's right.
But the Spirit will draw you.
That's right.
And once you come to it, he said, I will never drive you away. But he didn't say you can step out. But he said he'll never drive you away. And the God that we serve, even though you step out, he got his arms stretched out. So you can step right back in. Ain't that good news? We got some good news.
Good news.
Oh my God.
Yes, sir.
See, the thing about it here, Jesus did not work independently of God the Father, but in union, he worked together with him. Jesus' purpose was to do the will of God, not to satisfy his human desire. Can I get a witness? When we follow Jesus, we should have the same purpose. Let me tell you something. You got to get out your will. You got to get out your will and step in Jesus' will. Because when you step in his will, things will be a whole lot better. Can I get a witness here? Because your will might suit the world, but his will is going to take it and give you eternal life. And not only eternal life, he gonna help you while you down here. Can I get a witness here? But I'm so glad I'm thankful. He said, for I come down from heaven, not to do my will, but to do the will of him who sent me. And this is the will of him who sent me, that I should lose none of that he has given me, but raise them up in the last day. Now I stop by to tell you, if you're not in his will,
what will you?
You gotta watch it. Because you might not be one of his.
That's right.
There you go.
You gotta be careful.
Yeah.
See, degrees is wonderful. But he said, let this mind be in you as it was in Christ Jesus. See, you're not going to get that from the seminary. But God, once you get into the word and rightly divide the word, you begin to think like, and when people lie on you, when people say things, you say, what would Jesus do? Y'all, come on, help me out. What would Jesus do?
That's right.
See, you got got a serious problem. If you're doing the same thing you were doing before you met Christ. If you still got that spirit of retaliation or getting evil, you better check your salvation out. Can I get a witness out? Because the Bible said, what did he say? The battle. See, when you try to fight the battle, somebody gonna get hurt. Can I get a witness out? But when Jesus fight the battle, not only he working on the one that causing the problem, he's working on you also. Amen. Because you may not realize you can be part of the problem. Ah, can I get a witness out? Ah, I thank God about the good news. And he said that he's going to raise us up in the last day. Because somebody made a song and said, in the last day, when he come back, that even the oceans and the lakes and the rivers, Anacostia rivers and all the woods, gonna have to give up the dead in Christ. Can I get a witness there?
That's right.
They're gonna have to give it up. But one thing about it, I'm looking to be with him. Can I get a witness here? Yes. What Jesus said in the 39th verse, that he will not lose not one person who the Father has given him. Ain't that good news? Ain't that good news? Yes. He said, no, I will not lose one. See, all state can't say that. Hoffa can't say that. But Jesus said, I'm not going to lose not one of them. Long as you stay in his hand, do his will. Y'all come on, help me out. You'll be all right because eternal life will be yours. Can I get a witness here? Don't worry about being mistreated. Being mistreated, Jesus.
Yes.
And still talking about it.
That's right, that's right.
He told him, he said, we gonna be mistreated too.
That's right.
But great is our rewards in heaven. Lord have mercy. We got to walk upright. Let me tell you something here. Get one thing. Whatever you do, get one thing. If you're gonna do it for Jesus and perfect it. And perfect it. Stop trying to do three or four things. And ain't doing nothing. But messing up. He'd rather have you doing one thing. If you're going to be a flow sweeper, perfect.
Get a message.
Sweeping the flow. If you're going to be a window washer, be the best.
Amen, amen.
See, people want to be shamed. But Mother Carol, I promised the Lord. What went on in 17 is not going to go in the church on 18.
Amen.
If anybody retaliate or anything, you're in a position, you're coming down. If you try to admire somebody, that's not a godly way. If the Bible says you got to fall against somebody, you need to go to them. Can I get a witness out? See, we got to get away. Amen. God told me when he called us preachers, bishops, elders, apostles, he called us to be serious. This is not no play game up here. We got souls out there need to be saved. We can't let the devil come in the house and go rule the house. I don't care how long you've been here. I don't care if you like me or not. But if you retaliate, and if I see you, I know you're doing it on purpose. We made it today, but without a
That's right.
Try me and see. See if I can be. I never been to Vietnam, but I'm at war. I'm at war. And I'm trying to wipe the devil out every chance I get. Can I get a helper? Anybody trying to take him out? We got to take him out, church. And the only way we can take him out is through the word of God. If he abide in us and we abide in him, we can do his will, church. Lord have mercy. That's why I look at the mothers. That's why they're still here. Because they work hard for God. Because they are proud warriors. Can I get a witness here? Every now and then, you need to steal away. Tell God to fix my heart. Fix my mind. Can I get a witness here? Every now and then, you need to tell the Lord, baptize me with the Holy Ghost and fire. Can I get a witness here?
Yes.
For God is love. I thank God the Father for sending his son. That was good news. Can I get a witness here? And the son gave his life so we can have the right to the tree of life. Now we're on our way. Can I get a witness?
Yes.
To see the coming king. Because one of these days, and it won't be long, you're going to look for us, and we're going to be gone. But I'm going to heaven, we're going to finish out. Nobody there going to put us out, because we're going to have a good time.
Yes.
We're going to be with the 24 elders.
Yes.
Sitting around the throne, singing holy.
Holy is the Lamb.
Holy. Good news. Good news.
Yes.
Good news.
Good news.
You know, I'm going to close. God knows what's best for his children. All the things it behooves us to be ready. That's all.